Hey, everyone, welcome back to 996 The Howl. The Coyotes win 2-0 against the Anaheim Ducks and get their 7th road win of the season. Now, why is that important? It took them all 41 games last season to get 7 road wins. And this year, they do it in 18 games. They managed to hit the 7 road win mark. They also hit 40 points in their 35th game. Last season, it took them 51 games to hit the 40-point mark with a record of 17-28-6. This year, they're 19-14-2 to get that 40-point mark. Honestly, I think one of the best improved teams in the NHL from last season and this season. I would honestly only say that Canucks and Flyers could be in conversation with the most improved team. Another shutout for the Coyotes, it seems like that's the norm. 3 shutouts in 2 weeks, 4 in the month of December, 3 in 7 games. The Coyotes have won 6 out of their past 7 games. Things are just rolling, and they might continue to roll. They got a 5-game homestand starting the year 2024 against teams like Florida, the Islanders, Winnipeg, and the Flames. This could be it. This could be a pivotal moment in the season where they just take off. And then you mix in there, you know, the new year, the first quarter of the new year, we should be getting some arena news. This could get very, very good in a hurry. I think 2023 was the best calendar year. The Coyotes on ice only, the Coyotes and Coyotes fans have experienced since the calendar year of 2019. Now, hopefully 2024 doesn't end up how 2020 was. So let's get into this game. Tyson Nash had a great stat, rare stat by Tyson Nash. The Coyotes haven't scored in a first period in their previous 6 games. And I thought, wow, that's a pretty bad stat. But to be honest, maybe a bit of a deceiving bad stat. It's not like the Coyotes are losing games. They, like I said, lost 1 game in 6 games, and they haven't really lost, well, they haven't lost games, but having not scored in a first period hasn't really come to bite them from behind. Maybe that Ottawa game where they ended up going down 3-0 early, but still managed to win that game. So I thought that was a little nice tidbit. The first 5 minutes of this game, pretty quiet, and the Coyotes get a power play and they score. Keller, a one-timer from Schmaltz and Kerfoot, a beautiful sequence play there on the power play. Great to see the power play continue to click. They also had other chances. I thought the Coyotes had a great first period here. They're getting a lot of chances. And honestly, throughout this whole game, I thought the Coyotes had way, way more dangerous chances than the Ducks. Zucker was all alone in front of the net, in front of Gibson. He shoots it over the net. Dursey to Zucker, a one-timer, great save by Gibson. And then near the end of the first period, Carconi and McBain had some in-tight chances that they were denied. The Coyotes held the Anaheim Ducks to 0 shots in the last 8 minutes of this first period. They only outshot the Ducks 11-10, so pretty even in terms of shot quantity, but the quality was all Coyotes. Really liked how the Coyotes came out on the road. This was a perfect road game, just in terms of shutting the crowd pretty much quiet the whole game. Pretty consistent hockey play from the drop of the puck to the final whistle here. We go into second period, an early penalty kill. The Coyotes kill it off. There's some rough stuff between Bukestad and Strom. McBain gets in with it with Carrick. Carrick sucker punches McBain in the face while he's unaware in a scuffle. Carrick gets a 4-minute penalty for that. Coyotes have a power play. They failed it, but honestly, their power play looked really good tonight. Keller had a lot of good looks. I liked Keller's game tonight. And Dursey just, man, we really just missed his presence on the power play. And just in terms of keeping up offensive momentum while he was injured last week, maybe a couple weeks ago. And then after that failed power play, Kraus scores from Michelli. An incredible pass here. It's like threading a thread through a needle hole. I mean, pretty much, I've said this so many times before, it's like I'm repeating myself. Michelli passes it the whole length of the ice, through everybody, through all Coyotes players, through all Ducks players, finds Kraus all alone, who just one-times it past Gibson. His 16th goal, I believe, of the season. He leads the team in goals. Kraus is just having himself a year. He's going to surpass his career high total of 24 goals really soon. After the goal, Cooley to O'Brien. O'Brien hits the post. The Coyotes call off another penalty. And on this late second period penalty kill, you could hear the crowd so eager for the Ducks to score, so eager for the Ducks to do something so the crowd could celebrate. But the Coyotes just kept them to the outside. There were no real high danger saves Ingram had to make this game. He was solid. He did his job. But I thought the defense did a really good job blocking shots and just keeping all the shots pretty low quality. So we go into the third period, and immediately the Coyotes commit a penalty 30 seconds in. And, you know, you're on the road going into the third period. The home team has had nothing all game. 30 seconds into it, you give them a power play with a young, talented group like the Ducks. The crowd coming back from intermission with their last beer of the night. It was about to pop off, but thankfully the Coyotes keep them at bay. The Ducks don't score. The Coyotes go on their own power play. They fail at it. Gibson had a diving save, desperate save against a Michelli one-timer. And then, you know, Anaheim was pushing maybe in the middle of the third, and I think the last 10 minutes of the third period, the Ducks finally came alive and were just so desperate to get a goal here. They pulled their goalie 3 minutes left in the game, and those last 3 minutes, the Ducks were all over the Coyotes. Their first stretches of sustained offensive zone pressure the Ducks had, but Coyotes just shut it down. They win, and their last game of 2023, Coyotes power play 1-for-3, perfect on the penalty kill, 3-for-3. Faceoffs were pretty low, 41%, but they eclipsed the 30-shot mark and outshoot the Ducks 32-28. Winning 6 of 7 games, everything's just going the Coyotes' way, and this is still without, you know, Barrett Hayden in the lineup, a guy that does a lot of little details very well. But Kerfoot, I said it right when Hayden got injured, put Kerfoot on the top line. He's played with Matthews. He's played with Marner, Nylander, Tavares. Put him with skilled guys like Keller and Schmaltz. Kerfoot knows what to do. He does the little things, the dirty things. He goes to the front of the net. He is literally Barrett Hayden. And finally, it's been clicking the past, 5 or 7 games since he's been on that top line. Coyotes just got to keep it rolling. They got two goaltenders now who are playing really well. Vemelka's on a 4-game win streak. Ingram with another shutout. I'm pretty sure he leads the league in expected goals saved above expected, or however you want to pronounce that statistic. So we're going into a new year. A lot of positive vibes, positive buzz around the team. Honestly, I'm not there yet, but maybe, you know, fans of other teams or non-hockey fans, maybe they might want to start paying attention to this team. I don't think I'm there yet. I think right now Coyotes fans should be happy, but I don't think that should leave the Coyotes fans to other fans just yet. You know, you never know with injuries and what could happen. Things might go south, but for right now, they're exceeding expectations. They're doing everything right. Sure, they went long stretches of bad games, but you know, they stopped the bleeding and now winning 6 of 7, they're doing really well. And you can't really complain with 40 points at the end of December. Just a really good job by Andre Tourney and the staff and the players as well. They come prepared every game, and I'm liking a lot of how they've been playing the past 2 games. That's it for me. Thank you for watching. If you like what you see, spread the word. And as always, thank you for your support.